We'll get to Amy Winehouse and her biopic in just a bit. But first, let's talk about Taylor Swift and her becoming a billionaire.
Okay, so Taylor Swift is now officially on the artist billionaire list, but she's on there solely because of her concerts and music. So you have Jay-Z, Beyonce, Rihanna. I mean, for example, Rihanna, she has her makeup brand going for her. You know, she hasn't made music in forever, but, you know, understandable. Taylor Swift, solely concerts, solely music, which is insane. She's worth $1.1 billion.
It makes sense because when you think about it, she goes on tours that's over, like, 200 cities.
Yeah.
She also has her movie that just came out that,
yeah,
if I'm not mistaken, it was over 20 million that she got from that as well.
She got a hefty amount of money for,
yeah,
that movie. Yeah,
yeah. So it makes sense. It's smart that Travis Kelce jumped on her when he could, you know, before she was billionaire status. So
yeah,
now nobody can say he was there for her money, you know?
Yeah, I've been there since before the money, Taylor. What do you mean?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, and now he can reap all the benefits of being with a billionaire. It makes
okay,
perfect sense. I love that
smart
logic.
Smart.
Yeah, so smart. All right. Now, everybody is talking about Amy Winehouse because of this clip right here.
Cut the tire script, because I'm not going to meet your mother anytime.
So what's going on with that?
This clip of Amy Winehouse in the biopic singing with auto-tune just went viral for all the wrong reasons. Everyone's saying this does not sound like Amy Winehouse. What were they thinking? Why? Just like all caps, why? And I couldn't agree more because this just doesn't sound like her. It just doesn't.
You know what I think is going to happen now that they're getting so much backlash is they're going to go back and retake these scenes.
Because, you think
so? Oh, yeah, 100%. I don't know if you remember when Sonic the Hedgehog came out, the movie. In
oh,
the first,
yeah, and the teeth.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
The teeth. Everyone hated the teeth.
Everybody was like, what in the world did you do with the character? Then when the actual movie came out,
They fixed it. Yeah.
I think now that they're getting backlash on the vocals, they're mm-hmm. like, okay, nope, we didn't get it right. We need to go back and post and actually record better vocals, which I think should be done. You know, at
yeah.
the end of the day, you want to almost embody the character and you don't want people to think that it's not the character on screen. Or not character, the person on screen.
Yeah.
I seen Bob Marley, One Love. I forgot that it was a British guy playing Bob Marley.
It's insane.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So you want somebody like that. And I think if the music is not right, it's going to take away from the actual biopic. So I think they'll go back and fix it.
100%. And I mean, you have our actors like Austin Butler, who played Elvis in the biopic for Elvis, and he took his time training to be Elvis. And as much as people made fun of him for it, did he need to be made fun of? Like, at the end of the day, he did what he needed to do.
Exactly. And you didn't look at him like, hey, this is not Elvis. What,
yeah,
what
exactly.
This? Exactly. All right. Well, hopefully they learn from their mistakes.
Yeah.
They see the backlash and they fix the movie, because I'm super excited to see what this biopic is all
yeah.
about, because there's so many stories with Amy Winehouse that I would love to see and hear about,
mm-hmm.
some untold stories that we'll get to in that biopic, I'm
yeah.
sure. So once that come out, we'll definitely keep you updated and give you out critiques, all right?